In the previous video, I went over how to set up a standard folder structure and load the data onto ArcMap. In this video, I will show you how to create a 6x6-inch map and export it as a PNG file at a resolution of 300 dpi. Regarding the instructions on the Humboldt State Geospatial online website, I am currently on step 10. However, just for future reference, these numbers sometimes change, and someday they might go away altogether. In ArcMap, you should always design your maps in Layout View. From the menu at the top, go to View, then Layout View. When you switch to Layout View for the first time, the Layout toolbar will appear floating above the map. To keep things neat, just dock the toolbar at the top. Before starting your map, it is important to make sure that the map layout is the exact size and shape you plan to use it for. By default, ArcMap uses the printer settings, which is typically a page size of 8.5 by 11 inches. Unless you plan to use the map at this size, it is a really bad habit to accept these layout defaults when designing your map. So for example, if you needed a small 6x6-inch map for a report and designed the map using a layout of 8.5 by 11 inches, you would have to shrink the map down after the fact. Aside from annoying your professors, this makes your map hard to read. If you need a 6x6-inch map, design your map using a 6x6-inch layout. The point is to avoid resizing your map image later on. In this example, I'm going to design my map using a 6x6-inch layout. The map will be placed in a Microsoft Word document. The purpose of the maps will be to serve as a figure in a report or summary. They will show the map reader the data I plan to use in my analysis. When changing the layout size, there are always two steps. You need to change the paper size, then you need to change the data frame size. The first step is to change the paper size. To do this, go to File, then Page and Print Setup. Uncheck the box next to Use Printer Paper Settings. Then change the width and the height. Now the paper size is 6 inches, but the data frame is still 8.5 by 11. Right-click on the data frame and select Properties. Then go to the Size and Position tab. Enter 6 for the width and the height. For the position, enter 0 for the X and the Y value. Click OK when you are ready. I'll be making 3 maps out of the data I downloaded in the previous video. To start, I will uncheck the boxes in the table of contents for the parcel and zoning layers. That way, only the roads will appear with the Humboldt County boundary in the background. Next, I will zoom closer so that I can clearly see the roads layer. I'll focus on the area around Humboldt Bay. Once I have my map position and map scale where I want it, I'll create a spatial bookmark. Bookmarks are very handy. I can move the map or zoom way out and then use the bookmark to jump right back in. This is useful in this circumstance because I want to create several maps at the same position and scale. The bookmark will ensure that all my maps have an identical scale and position. Next, I will adjust the colors on my map. To start, I'll change the background to blue, which will simulate water features around the bay. Open the data frame properties and navigate to the Frame tab. Change the background to blue. While I'm here, I'll also adjust the map border. Next, I'll change the colors of the county boundary and the roads. ArcMap assigns random colors when you load the layers onto the map. You should never rely on the default colors. Always make a conscious choice about what you want your map to look like. I want a place to add a scale bar and a north arrow. The problem is that my map is a little busy with all the roads. Sometimes it is useful to create a background for map elements. I'll do this by drawing a rectangle across the bottom. Right-click anywhere on the gray area on the top and activate the Draw toolbar. When you first open the Draw toolbar, it appears floating above the map. To keep things neat, just dock the toolbar at the bottom. Select the Rectangle tool and draw a background area for your map elements. By default, the rectangle is yellow. You can change the color by right-clicking the rectangle and opening the Properties window. Here you can change the fill and outline colors. You can also use the Size and Position tab to adjust the width and the height, as well as the position on the map. Now you can insert a scale bar and a north arrow without the road features cluttering the space. Make sure the scale bar is set to an even number that is easy for the map reader to add together. In this example, I'll make it an even 10 miles. There is also room to insert a simple legend for the roads. I don't think I need to include the Humboldt County boundary in my legend. I think it will be self-explanatory in this circumstance. Be sure to always delete the word legend. As a rule of thumb, always include a descriptive legend title or leave it out altogether. In this instance, I don't think I need a legend title. For the last detail, I'm going to change the layer name to something more user-friendly. Right-click on the Roads layer in the Table of Contents and navigate to the General tab. Call the layer Humboldt County Roads. Notice that the legend updates automatically. Now is a good time to set the map document properties and save your map document. Go to File and select Map Document Properties. Check the box next to Store Relative Path Names. This setting will allow you to move your top-level folder to a different location or a different computer without breaking your data. As a rule of thumb, always be sure this is turned on and you'll save yourself a lot of headaches. Now go ahead and save your map document. I'm going to save it in my top-level folder, Music Festival 1. Some people like to save it to the working folder, but I like to park it right outside. As long as it is somewhere in the top-level folder for the project you are working on and you can find it later, you should be fine. Untitled is a terrible name, and using it as a file name is a really bad habit to get into. Always give your files meaningful names. I'll call this one Music Festival 1. To export the map, go to File, then Export Map. This is another place where students make mistakes. Don't rush the next few steps. Navigate to the folder where you want to save the map image. In this example, I'm saving it to my final folder. I'll call the file Roads Map. Change the file type to PNG. Always use at least 300 dpi for the resolution. Otherwise, your map may look fuzzy and pixelated. Your professors will dock points if your map looks blurry. When you are ready, click Save. Now open your final folder. You should see the image file. Next, I'll create two more maps, one for the parcels layer and one for the zoning layer. I can use the same map layout. In ArcMap, uncheck the boxes in the table of contents for the roads and Humboldt County boundary. Turn on the parcels layer. Navigate to the Symbology tab and select categories from the list on the left. For the value field, set it to EXLU4 and uncheck the box next to all other values. Click the Add All Values button, then click OK. As you can see, the map is color-coded by the EXLU4 field, which indicates land use. However, the outlines make the map illegible in very dense areas like downtown Eureka. Return to the Symbology tab to get rid of the outlines. Right-click on the word symbol above the colored rectangles and choose Properties for All Symbols. Change the outline color to no color. Now the map is a little easier to read. Insert a new legend for the parcels layer. For the legend title, enter Land Use Categories. Give the legend a light background color and a border. For now, accept the defaults for the rest of the settings. The legend is quite large, but you can adjust the size to fit on the map. It is also helpful to change the legend style so that only the legend title is displayed. From the Properties window, navigate to the Items tab. Click the Style button on the lower left. There are many styles to choose from. The second one down on the left side will display only the legend title. You may need to resize the legend again after changing styles. Another option you can try is to only show classes that are currently visible. Return to the Items tab and check the box that says only show classes that are visible in the current map extent. You can spend a lot more time making this map look better. However, for our purposes, it's best to keep it simple. Export this map layout and save the file as a PNG at 300 dpi. Name the file Parcels. Repeat these steps for the zoning layer. Call the layer Zones. Use the field named Abbreve to symbolize the map. Change the legend properties so that the title says Zone Categories and the zoning layer is displayed. Adjust the style and the legend size as needed. When you are ready, export the zone map. Before moving on to the next step, take a moment to save your map document. In the next video, I will show you how to download data from the USDA NRCS Geospatial Data Gateway.